Welcome back. We had so far discussed all the three methods which we use to solve the linear equations in two variables. The very first method that we discussed was substitution method. Then we used elimination method. And then it was cross multiplication. These all three methods are the algebraical methods. And one more method that is left is graphical method. These are the methods by which we can solve the linear equations. We had discussed substitution method, we had discussed elimination method, we had discussed cross multiplication method. Now we will discuss one application of cross multiplication method today, and then we will come to our graphical method. The question is, find A and B if these two equations 2x plus 3y equals to 7, this is first equation, and A minus B times x, A plus B times y is equals to 3a plus B minus 2, this is second equation. These are having infinite number of solutions. Now recall what we did yesterday. We discussed that two linear equations of the form a1x b1y plus c1 equals to 0 and a2x b2y plus c2 equals to 0 will have infinite number of solutions if a1 upon a2 is equals to b1 upon b2 is equals to c1 upon c2. Remember? So in this question we are given that they are having infinite number of solutions, so it means a1 upon a2 will be equals to b1 upon b2, which will further equals to c1 upon c2. Now what is a1? A1 is the coefficient of x, that is 2, upon a2. A2 is coefficient of x in second equation, that is a minus b. When we talk about the coefficient, it means if we are talking about coefficient of x, means leave x and whatever left is the coefficient. Yahan pe bhi x ko chhod do, jo bach gaya wo coefficient hai, that is a minus b. Then put equals to b1 upon b2. b1 is 3 and b2 is a plus b. Similarly, c1 is 7 and c2 is 3a plus b minus 2. I told you yesterday that in cross multiplication method, the right hand side should be 0. Only in cross multiplication method, this is the condition that right hand side should be 0. In other questions, in any of the other form of solving the linear equations, it is up to you whether you want to make the right hand side 0 or not. So here we are not using cross multiplication because we are simply using the concept a1 upon a2 equals to b1 upon b2 equals to c1 upon c2. So no need to make the right hand side 0. So it is okay if you will proceed with this only. Now to solve this, how is it going to happen? We cannot solve three equations simultaneously. First of all, we will solve these two and then we will solve these two. Or it is up to you. First of all, you can solve first and second and then first and third also. It is up to you. So first of all, from first and second term, from first and second component, you can also say, we will get 2 upon a minus b is equals to 3 upon a plus b. Now how to solve? Only the method is cross multiply both sides. So what you will get? 2 times a plus b is equals to 3 times a minus b, which means 2a and then 2 times b will become 2b is equals to 3 times a, 3a, then minus 3b. Now transpose all these terms to the left hand side, it will be 2a plus 2b minus 3a, and this minus 3b will become plus 3b and right hand side will become 0. Now 2a minus 3a, it will be plus minus minus, so it will be a only, but minus 3 was bigger number which is negative, so answer will be negative. 2b plus 3b, it will be 5b, which is equals to 0. So this is my first equation. If you have already marked equation number 1 and equation number 2, then you can mark it as equation number 3. But no problem, because okay, it was not visible. Now is it okay? Yes. But because we hadn't used this number so earlier in the question, so you can skip this. No need to mark these equations. This is my question number one. Now, as I solved first and second, now from you want, then you can solve second and third, or if you want, you can solve first and third also. What you want, I guess we will proceed. We should proceed with second and third. From second and third component, 3 upon a plus b is equals to 7 upon 3a plus b minus 2. Cross multiply it. Just a minute. So now multiply this 3 with 3a plus b minus 2. So it will be 3 times 3a plus b minus 2, which will be equals to 7 times a plus b. Isn't it coming? Now multiply it. 3 times a is 9a. 3 times b is 3b. Then multiply this with minus 2, minus 6 is equals to 7a, then 7b. Transpose all these terms to the right, left hand side. 9a plus 3b minus 6 we will transpose to the right hand side. So bring these minus 7a and this will become minus 7b equals to minus 6 will become plus 6 because it is transposing to the right hand side. Clear? Now 9a minus 7a it is 2a. 3b minus 7b it is minus 4b because 7 is bigger number which is negative is equals to 6. This is the second equation. Now we know that all the coefficients are here multiple of 2, so we can divide by 2 to make the question simpler. If you don't want, then you can proceed from here only, but I will make the question simpler by dividing the whole equation by 2. So it will give me a minus 2b is equals to 3. If I'll divide this by 2, it'll be a only. If I'll divide this by 2, it'll be 2b. And if I'll divide 6 by 2, it'll give me 3. So this is my second equation. Now, from equation number 1 and equation number 2, you have to solve these equations. Now, we had so far discussed all the three algebraical methods to solve the linear equations in two variables, so you can use any of the two methods. What I found easier is elimination method over here, because in first equation I am having minus a plus 5b equals to 0, and in second equation a minus 2b equals to 0. Here coefficient of a are already same, that's why I chose elimination method. Now a minus a will get cancel out, plus minus minus it is 3b and is equals to 3. So which means b is equals to 3 upon 3, b is coming out to be 1. Now if b is 1, substitute this value of b in any of the two equations, either in 1 or in 2. If I'll put b is equals to 1 in 2, what it'll give me? A minus 2 times b. B is 1 is equals to 3. If it is not visible to you, clear? So it is a minus 2 is equals to 3. A is equals to 3, minus 2 will get plus over here, a is equals to 5. So this is the solution, a equals to 5 and b is equals to 1. The question was, let's recall the question. The question was find a and b if these equations have infinitely many solutions. So a and b are coming out to be 1, 5 and 1. Thank you.